हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? वेलकम बैक टू एक्टिव इंग्लिश चिल्ड्रेन। यस, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ न्यू चैप्टर फ्रॉम एक्टिव इंग्लिश। आफ्टर योर एसे वन वी आर गोइंग टू डू अ न्यू लेसन चिल्ड्रेन, एक्टिव इंग्लिश चैप्टर नंबर 21। Are you ready with the pencil and eraser? Are you writing the date every time whenever you sit for writing? You have to. Children, you have already learned about the position words. Now, what is the meaning of position words? You know that. I have a box over here. Yes, children? If I say this box I am keeping here, so it is on. Correct? Now, today we are going to learn about the word where. The word where it is used for. That is for position. The word where is used for position. And also place. Position just now I showed you on place. If I say you have to go to restaurant, so that is restaurant is a place. Am I right? Now, examples of position words are in. Can I say now this? If I keep the pencil in the box, it is in. Now, on, under. Then it's behind. Now this is my beast. So this is behind. It's near. It's beside. Yes, children. So these are the examples of position words. You should be able to give me the answers. Now look here, children. Who are they? Two boys are there. What is this boy in the blue shirt asking? The boy wearing the blue shirt is asking to his friend, where are you going? So he wants to know where is he exactly going. Now the boy in the yellow shirt says, I am going to my house. I am going to my house. That is place. Now, see, this boy again is asking, where is your house? The friend in yellow shirt is saying, near the temple. My house is near the temple. That means he is showing the location of his house. It's a place. Now, children, so today we are going to use and write the sentence. How we are going to use the sentence now? See. Yes, look at the first picture, children. In the first picture, there is a bottle in the box. The bottle is kept in the box, children. The question is, where is the bottle? You have to give me the answer. Reply after me. Or, yes, you have to try by yourself, children. The first, we'll begin with it. And the first letter has to be capital. It is, then it's a dash, the box. What are you going to fill in it? Options are given. Now look at the picture number 1. The bottle is kept. Where is the bottle? It is in the box. So you are going to write, it is in the box. So what will you write? I-N, in. It is in the box. Now, look at the क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. आई होप यू मस्ट हैव फिनिश्ड बाय नाउ. रीड द क्वेश्चन. वेयर? यस, देयर इज अ ब्लैंक. नाउ वी हैव टू फिल दैट डैश. व्हाट डू वी हैव टू राइट इन दैट? चिल्ड्रन ऑल्सो रिमेंबर व्हाइल राइटिंग द सेंटेंस अबाउट सिंगुलर एंड प्लूरल. सिंगुलर इज फॉर इज एंड प्लूरल आर. When there are many things, many objects are kept, we say are. Now look at the apples in the plate. Now just tell me how many apples are kept? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 apples. Okay, so we are going to write beside where are. Where are the apples? A-R-E-R. Have you finished writing? Now, see, the first letter will begin with capital. Very good. So, you all know the first letter will begin with capital. So, you are writing, children. Now, look at the option given below. Yes, where are the apples? There is a plate and the apple is on the plate. But the first we are going to begin with they. Then beside they, A-R-E-R. What is the spelling of they? T-H-E-Y, they. They are, then, yes children, correct. You have to write on. You will write on the plate. They are on the plate. And at the end, you are going to put a full stop. You will begin with capital letter and at the end, you are going to put a full stop. Now, repeat the sentence after me. Where are the apples? They are on the plate. Correct. Now let us go for question number 3. Now look at the picture. What is that? Oh, it's a table. Then, yes, under the table something has been kept. First, let us complete the question. Where? Next to where? What will you write? Yes, correct. So you are giving the answers also. Where is the bottle? What are you going to write? Where is the bottle? So your word will begin with think. Are you thinking? Yes, option is given. The bottle is kept under. And begin with yes, it. It is under the table. First, you are going to write it. It. It is under the table. And spelling of under is U-N-D-E-R. Under. Correct. Yes, you should by heart the spellings also, children. Without biting, knowing the spellings, you can't write the sentence. Yes, now let us proceed for the next question. Question number 4. Look at the picture. There is one girl and a boy. And what about the question? Oh, there is no question. So my children have to make. What will be your question first? What will be the first word? We are talking about, we are learning about which word in the lesson? Where. So, first you will write, yes, where. Then, think. Correct. You are going to write, where is the boy? Where is the boy standing, children? option are, yes, option is given below. Read the spelling. BEHIND. Behind. So the boy is behind the girl. And what is the meaning of behind? This is my fist. And where is the box? Now, behind. So the boy is behind the girl. You will begin with he. H is in capital letter. He is behind the girl. Girl spelling is G-I-R-L, girl. And at the end, you are going to put a full stop. So question number 4 is, where is the boy? He is behind the girl. Are you getting it, children? Write in good handwriting. Now look here. Question number 5. In the picture, you can see a boy and a girl. Now there is a big dash given. No question is written. You have to frame a question. So you will begin with where. And what is the spelling of where? W-H-E-R-E, where. Think now. Beside where you are going to write? Yes. Where is the girl? Where is the girl, children? The girl is standing here and the boy is beside. The boy is beside. You sit beside your friend. Yes? You are happy when you sit beside your friend. So beside means it's here. Now, for girl, what are you going to write? You will use the pronoun she. Yes, you have learned this also, children. So you should be able to understand and write. S-H-E, she. She is beside the boy. Where is the girl? She is beside the boy. And then put a full stop. So your sentence is ready. Now look at the question number 6. Question number 6. There is a tree. Yes. And what is that standing? Goat. It is a goat, children. Now you have to frame a question. So your question will begin with where? Where is the goat? G-O-A-T, goat. It's a question. Where is the goat? It's a question. Now after framing the question, you have to write the sentence. Now see, the option is given in front of. Where is the box? In front of. Yes, it is in front of the tree. Right, it is in front of the tree. Front spelling is F-R-O-N-T, front. Understood? Now let us go for the next question. Question number 7. Yes, it's on the second page, children. Now see the second page. Look at the picture first. Yes. Can you guess what is the picture about? Yes, let us write now. Correct. Where is the woman? Where is the woman, children? Think. your answer will begin with yes, children. So you are giving me the answers. She is in the boat. There is a boat and the woman is sitting in the boat. Yes, she is going on a journey. She is traveling by the boat. She is in the boat. And what is the boat spelling? B-O-A-T. No options. You should by heart the spellings also, children. Now look at the question number 2. What is that, children? Oh, I can see cats in the picture. Then, how will you frame the question? Yes, there is not one cat, but there are more than one. So, more than one means, you are going to write R. You are going to write R. So, for many, we use the verb R, helping verb R. Where are the cats? Where are the cats, children? The question is, where are the cats? You have to say the position of the cats. Yes, when they are many. So, we use the word they. You will write pronoun they. You have to use the pronoun they. T-H-E-Y, they. Then, beside they, you are going to write R. Then, where are the cats sitting? On. The cats are sitting on the chair. So, you will write, they are on the chair. Understood, children? Question number 3 now. What is that, children? It's a chair. Oh, yes. Who is that? Dog. Now first frame the question. Ready? Yes. Where is the dog? Where is the dog sitting, children? So how will you begin the answer? Good, children. It is under the chair. Where is the dog? It is under the chair. The dog is sitting under the chair. And the chair spelling is C-H-A-I-R, chair. Good, children. Very good. Now, let us move towards next question. What is that? I can see a tree. And a which animal? Cow. Yes, first frame the question now. Where is the cow? Where is the cow, children? Can you give me the answer? Now, the cow is, yes, the cow is behind the tree. It has gone behind. So, how will you write the sentence? It is behind the tree. And what is the spelling of behind? B-E-H-I-N-D, behind. It is behind the tree. Correct. Writing. Good. Neat work I want. Okay, children. Now, look at this question number 5. Yes, a man and a woman. Now, first frame the question. Where is the woman? Where is the woman standing, children? Yes, think. Correct answer, children. She is beside the man. Where is the woman standing? She is standing beside the man. And what is the spelling of beside? B-E-S-I-D-E, beside. Understood? Now, let us move towards 6th question. Oh, what is that, children? It's a cat. Frame the question now. Where is the cat? Where is the cat, children? Where is the cat? Think? Yes, correct. So you know now to frame the sentence also, children. For? Yes, for animal we use it. So it is in front of the box. You should be able to write the spellings by yourself also, children. The spellings of beside, in front of, behind, near, and then you can frame the sentence very easily. It is in front of the box. Understood? Yes, children. I gave you today where word and I asked you to write the sentences. You had to frame the sentences, children. Now, children, today I brought something different for you. Yes, it's activity time. In this activity time, I brought today riddles for you. I want to know how smart my children are. I know my children are very smart and they all think and give the answers. So, today let us have something change. Now, first one. I am a piece of furniture. I am a piece of furniture. You sleep on me. Who am I, children? Think. Think, who am I? Guess. Yes. The answer is bed. Very good. I didn't want to give you the answer actually. But then I thought, let me begin with the answers first. And my children are thinking, they are very smart. They know the answers. So it's a piece of furniture, you sleep on me. And then who am I? It's a bed. Now, on number two, the girl is thinking, now see, I have four legs. I have four legs. You keep plate. You keep plate and eat food. And eat food. Who am I? Who am I, children? Think. Think. I have four legs. You keep plate and eat food. Yes. Give correct answer. It's a table. Table has four legs. And you keep a plate and what that plate has? Food. And then you eat? Yes, very good, children. So you are giving me the answers quickly. Now, see this question number three. You see my rights. You see my rights and enjoy here. You come and enjoy here and you see so many rights over here. Who am I? Think, who am I? So many rides and enjoy. Yes, correct answer, children. It's a garden. It's a place where you go and enjoy so many rides. Now, look at the fourth question, children. I am tall. When I am young. I am tall when I am young. And I am short when I am old. Who am I? When you are young, you are tall. But when you become old, you are short. Who am I? Think. Think. Think, children. Shall I count? Tick tick one, tick tick two, tick tick three, Yes? Yes, children. Correct answer. It is candle. So, a candle is tall when it is young. But when we lit the candle, it decreases, the size reduces, it becomes old and it becomes short, children. So, you gave me the correct answer, children. And have you enjoyed the riddles? So, your activity was good. I hope, children, you will write the answers also by yourself. Listen properly. Think. Go through the lessons again and again. Learn the spellings and then learn to frame the sentences and the questions. Okay? Now, it's time to go, children. Thank you, children. I hope you all are listening to your parents. Listen to them, obey them, and do your work regularly. Bye, children. Take care.